I'm Dr. Parimita Gupta, Department of Zoology, SS Memorial College, Kake Road, Ranchi. This is for Semester 6, Zoology Specific Paper, DSC 4, Unit 9, Vaccines. In this you have to read types of vaccines, recombinant vaccines and the DNA vaccines. So in a very short illustration, we have to know what are vaccines. A vaccine is a biological preparation that provides active acquired immunity to a particular infectious disease. A vaccine typically contains an agent that resembles a disease-causing microorganism and is often made from weakened or killed forms of the microbes, its toxins, or on one of its surface proteins. Okay? So now what are the types of vaccines? Basically the vaccines can be divided into two main types. The first type can be live attenuated vaccines and the second part can be inactivated vaccines. Fine. What are these live attenuated vaccines? The live attenuated vaccines contain whole bacteria or viruses which have been weakened so that they create a protective immune response but do not cause disease in healthy people. Alright, so the live vaccines tend to create a strong and lasting immune response and are some of our best vaccines. However, live vaccines are not suitable for people whose immune system does not work, either due to drug treatment or underlying illness. This is because the weakened viruses or bacteria can multiply too much and might cause disease in these people. The live attenuated vaccines used in the in today's medical terms or the treatments that are rotavirus vaccine, these are MMR vaccine, nasal flu vaccine, shingles vaccine, chickenpox vaccine, some special group of this, and BCG vaccines against TB, that is again a special group. Okay, the live travel vaccine used as such here are yellow fever vaccine, oral typhoid vaccine. These are not injected vaccines. Oral typhoids are not injected vaccines. So now the inactivated vaccines is, the inactivated vaccines contain whole bacteria or virus which have been killed, or small parts of the bacteria or viruses such as proteins or sugars which cannot cause disease. There are several different types of inactivated vaccines which are as such. Like, because inactivated vaccines do not contain any live bacteria or viruses, they cannot cause the diseases against which they protect. Even in people with several weakened immune system, however, inactivated vaccines do not always create such a strong or long-lasting immune response as live vaccines does. Alright, so they usually require repeated doses or booster doses. Adjuvants such as aluminium salts are often added to inactivated vaccines. Now, these are substances which help to strengthen the lengthening to immune the response to the vaccine. As a result, common local reactions may be more noticeable and frequent with the inactivated vaccines. Suppose a whole, the first part can be taken as a whole killed vaccines. What are these? These vaccines contain whole killed viruses. There are currently no vaccines used as whole killed viruses after the whooping cough vaccine that has been taken back in the year 2004. Inactivated polio vaccine or IPV, alright, some inactivated flu vaccines which are described as split virion and hepatitis A vaccine special groups are all incorporated in this whole killed vaccines. Some of the whole killed vaccines examples are also rabies vaccine and Japanese encephalitis vaccine. Okay, next is subunit vaccines, sometimes called as acellular vaccines. So what are these? Most of the vaccines in the United Kingdom schedule are subunit vaccines which do not contain any whole bacteria or viruses at all. Instead, these kinds of vaccines contain polysaccharides, that is sugars or proteins from the surface of bacteria or viruses. Now, these polysaccharides or proteins are the parts that our immune system recognizes as foreign body, and they are referred to as antigens. Even though the vaccine might only contain a few out of the thousands of the proteins in a bacterium, they are enough in themselves to trigger an immune response which can protect against the diseases. There are several different types of subunit vaccines, like the toxoid vaccines. Some bacterial releases toxins, alright, when they attack the body. The immune system recognizes these toxins in the same way that is it recognizes polysaccharides or proteins on the surface of the bacteria. Some vaccines are made with inactivated versions of these toxins. They are called toxoid because they look like toxins but are not poisonous. They trigger a strong immune response. So some examples of toxoid vaccines can be diphtheria vaccine. Alright, can be a tetanus vaccine, a pertussis vaccine. This contains pertussis toxoid together with proteins. The next, again a type is conjugate vaccines. Conjugate means connected or joined. Okay? In the early days of polysaccharide vaccines made by using sugars from the surface of bacteria, it was found that they did not work well in the babies and young children. So the researchers discovered that they worked much better if the polysaccharide was attached to something else that they knew created a strong immune response. So in most conjugate vaccines, the polysaccharide is attached to diphtheria or tetanus toxoid protein. The immune system recognizes these proteins very easily, and this helps to generate a stronger immune response to the polysaccharides. On product information sheets, the diphtheria toxoids is often called CRM197 carrier protein because it is almost the same as diphtheria toxoid, but not quite. Okay. Some of the examples of this conjugate vaccines, that is HIB vaccine, that is MEN-C vaccine, MEN-C ACWY vaccines. You have to learn the names of these vaccines. Next, you have to also read about the recombinant vaccines. Okay, this is very, very easy and important. The recombinant vaccines are made using bacterial or yeast cells to manufacture the vaccine. A small piece of DNA is taken from the virus or bacterium against which we want to protect. This is inserted into other cells to make them produce large quantities of active ingredient for the vaccines. For example, to make the hepatitis B vaccine, part of the DNA from the hepatitis B virus, it is inserted into the DNA of the yeast cells. Now, these yeast cells are then able to produce one of the surface proteins from the hepatitis B viruses, and this is purified and used as an active ingredient in the vaccine. So the recombinant vaccines nowadays that are used are the hepatitis B vaccine, that is an example of recombinant vaccine, the HPV vaccine, MEN-B vaccine. This contains proteins from the surface of meningococcal bacteria. Three of the proteins are made using recombinant technology. Other examples can also be like inactivated flu vaccines, PPV, which contains polysaccharide from the surface of 23 types of bacteria which causes pneumococcal diseases. Some of the examples is injected typhoid vaccine or the polysaccharide vaccine. All right, there is one thing that again that you have to study is the DNA vaccines. Alright, so what we see in the DNA vaccines. So the DNA vaccine is a technology for protecting against diseases by injection with genetically engineered plasmid containing the DNA sequence encoding the antigens against which an immune response is sought. So cells directly produce an antibody producing a protective immunological response. DNA vaccines have potential advantages over conventional vaccines, including the ability to induce a wider range of immune response. All right? So, I think we can also read some of the kinds of the DNA vaccines. All right? The different kinds of the DNA vaccines that we have, for example, DNA vaccines. The DNA vaccines represent an innovative approach allowing the induction of humoral and cell-mediated antigen-specific immune response in systematic and mucosal compartments. Vaccines consist of plasmid DNA encoding antigens that become expressed in host cells, including species-specific post-translational modifications. Now, the DNA vaccines elicit CD8 T cells responses in most experiments through cross-presentation of antigen, because most pathogens invade hosts through mucosal surfaces. The induction of mucosals and systematic immunity is of paramount importance, although systematic DNA vaccines exhibit high efficiency. Generally, weaker immune responses are induced by mucosal DNA administration. However, systematic immunization with selected viral and bacterial vaccines may also protect against mucosal infections. Furthermore, in contrast to high immunogenicity confirmed in small experimental animals, human DNA vaccines require further optimization to exhibit a protective effect. All right. So the DNA vaccine technology is based on the injection of DNA plasmids that encode the G protein. The plasmid thus injected integrates the host cell and encodes the immunogenic protein. DNA vaccines can be adjuvanted to improve their efficacy. The use of DNA vaccines may be an alternative to adjuvanted inactivated vaccines and live attenuated vaccines. This technology is adapted to fight against viruses that induce protein-based immunity and has the ability to induce immunity against several pathogens at the same time, and could be used orally as well. The field and laboratory trials compared a DNA vaccine and an adjuvanted inactivated vaccine produced in a cell culture. They demonstrate that the DNA vaccine has the ability to induce a higher level of antibodies and for up to 4 years after a single injection. So this is very, very, very important. The flavivirus detection vaccines are the DNA vaccines. The respiratory virus vaccines, the DNA influenza vaccines, these are the common vaccines that are used nowadays. The genetic vaccine for cancer is again use as a examples of DNA vaccines. The DNA and the recombinant protein vaccines are also some of the examples of the plasmid DNA vaccines. These are again some of the examples of the DNA vaccines. Thank you.